As the Earth floats around in space, it makes three basic fundamental movements. The first is called galactic movement. Can you guess what galactic movement happens in? It's within the Milky Way galaxy, our galaxy. There are billions of stars within the Milky Way galaxy, and presumably some very large number of planets, just like our own solar system. The Milky Way swirls around, as you can see on the left-hand side, although obviously we have not been so far out in space that somebody took this picture. This is a depiction. And if you look on the right-hand side, you can see there's the Milky Way galaxy swirling around, and we are all the way out on one end of it, on one of those arms that swirls around. It takes several hundred million years for the Milky Way to make one full revolution around itself. When you look up into the sky on a clear night and you see all of those shining things in the sky, everything you are looking at is in the Milky Way galaxy. If you know where to look, you might be able to see on a clear night a fuzzy little dot, which is the closest galaxy to us, Andromeda. Other than that, you cannot see with the naked eye any other things. Everything is within the Milky Way galaxy that you can see, and know this. There are not only billions of stars within the Milky Way galaxy, there are billions of galaxies with billions of stars in each one of them. And we sit out on the edge of our galaxy. Not too long ago, I was up in the central coast of California. And when it got dark at night, I walked out onto the coast and looked up over the ocean, and I could see this band of stars going across the sky. That's the Milky Way galaxy. It cuts across the sky. There it is right there. And remember that when you're looking up on a clear night and you see that, everything you're seeing is in the Milky Way, and you're looking into the center of the Milky Way galaxy from way out there on the edge. So the first movement is galactic movement. The second movement is revolution. This is what we do around the sun. In module 2, I'm going to speak much more about this, but for now, what you need to know is that this is what gives us our 365 and a quarter day year. The third movement is rotation. Rotation gives us our 24 hour day. This is how we have our clock. And if we're rotating around something. That thing is called the axis, which is the imaginary line between the North and South Poles around which the Earth rotates. You can see, if you look at this diagram, that those yellow arrows are pointing at the axis. It's that red line. Now, the axis, of course, is not a physical object. You can't reach out and touch it. But at one end of the axis is the North Pole, and at the other end of the axis is the South Pole. You can see them very clearly right there, North Pole and South Pole. And if we're rotating, and we are, we must be rotating some direction. The direction we rotate is west to east. If you think about it like this, if it's 9 a.m. on the west coast of North America, what time is it on the east coast of North America? 3 p.m. Very good. The time zones are stationary. They don't move. The Earth moves into them. And so if you're on the west coast of North America and it's 9 a.m., if it's ever going to be 3 p.m., you have to go where the East Coast is. And that means that you have to be moving from west to east. And you could tell, because the East Coast, at least from California, is about 2,100 miles away. We're moving at about 700 miles an hour, at least in Southern California. So pretend this for a moment. Pretend that in the room that you're sitting in, there's a beach ball hanging from the ceiling 5 or 6 feet away from you. And pretend like the beach ball looks like the Earth and it's blown up. If you were the sun and you were looking at that beach ball, how much of it can you see at any one moment? That's right, half. The sun and the Earth operate in a very similar way. If you look at this diagram on the right-hand side, you can see there's the sun. On the left-hand side, you can see there's the Earth. And at any one time, half of the Earth is illuminated and half of the Earth is in darkness. In other words, half the Earth has daylight, half the Earth has nighttime. Can you see that? Half of the Earth is illuminated and half of the Earth is in darkness. The line that divides the sunlit half from the darkened half of the Earth is called the circle of illumination. And you can see it very clearly on that diagram. Crossing the circle of illumination is experienced as sunrise or sunset. So for most people on the planet, in the morning, they're going to experience sunrise. Of course, the sun isn't really rising. The sun is stationary, and the Earth is turning into the lit half. And then the sun appears to go across the sky from east to west, but in reality, it's the Earth that's turning, and the only thing during the day that we have that's outside of our Earth system that gives us something to look at as a point of recognition is the sun. Everything within our Earth system is moving with us at the speed that we're rotating. And then when the evening rolls along, we rotate out of the lit half into the darkened half, and we experience that as sunset.